Sure, we can make bar charts and line charts in Excel, but did you know we can also make all of these? If you're curious about what's possible in Excel, or if you'd like some tips for getting started, stick around. This video is for you. I'm Anne Emery. You're watching Dataviz On The Go, the series where I make quick tutorials as I'm racing around between workshops. And speaking of workshops, I really need to pack for the airport. I fly to South Africa in just a few hours to teach Dataviz, so let's get to it. Let's make this quick. All right, a moment ago, I showed you all of these really advanced, really sophisticated charts in Excel, but we're not going to start there. We're actually going to start with the basics. I've organized all of the charts into 3 levels based on how easy or how complicated they are to make in Excel. Some are easier than others. There's definitely a learning curve. You've been warned, but just stick with it. It's worth the learning curve, I promise. So first up, as you're getting started with Excel, or you know, maybe you learned it years ago and your skills are a little bit rusty, I want you to start with level 1, overused native charts. Native charts are system charts or built-in charts. It's when you go to the Insert tab, they're there. These are going to be your familiar faces that you've seen a million times before. You've seen pies, donuts, bars, columns, clustered bars, clustered columns, stacked bars, stacked columns, line charts. These are fine. They're familiar. They're easy to make. But they get a little bit boring if that's all you have. If your reports and slideshows and dashboards just have these, meh. And more importantly than just the look is they're going to lack some analytical depth. Bar charts, for example, are fine for showing averages or totals, but there's a lot beyond just averages and just totals that we need to communicate to our audience. So that's where all of the other chart types can come in and save the day. Another caveat to these chart types is we got to edit them. Of course, we have to make sure that they are big A and little A accessible. This is what all of my other blog posts and YouTube tutorials are all about. If you've got questions about accessibility, just comment below the video and I'll post some resources and point you in the right direction. Once you've tackled level 1 skills, you can move on to level 2, the underused native charts. These are there, but a lot of them are newish or kind of hiding a little bit, so you might not have seen them or you might not be using them yet. This is going to include things like tree maps, sunburst diagrams for nested data, part to whole with more part to whole patterns, combo charts, overlapping bar charts and column charts for tracking progress towards goals, area charts, slope charts, small multiples, line charts, bump charts for showing rankings, heat maps. Did you know maps are in Excel? They're newish. Excel can also make scatter plots for X and Y and bubble charts for X, Y, and Z. Just like before, though, beware, you still have to roll up your sleeves and make some intentional edits. But I'd say it's worth it because look how nice your report or slide deck or dashboard is going to look with more variety and more analytical depth. For example, if you add a map, it shows that you've done the thinking behind the scenes to see if there are any geographical patterns. Or if you add a scatter plot, it means you've done the critical thinking behind the scenes to look for correlations between your variables. After you've made some beginner and intermediate charts, you're going to be ready for level 3, the non-native charts. Non-native means when you go to the Insert tab and you look for that chart type, it's not going to be there. But that doesn't mean it's not possible. It just requires some behind-the-scenes magic skills, which I'll tell you more about in a moment. These charts are going to include bark charts, bar arc charts, waffle charts, which are like square pies, small multiples bar charts for disaggregating subgroups, diverging stacked bars, population pyramids, which are 2 histograms, tilted on the side so you can see if distributions are symmetrical or not between groups, box and whisker diagrams, lollipop charts, dumbbell dot plots or with arrows to show directionality, swarm plots for small ends, tile grid heat maps, tile grid, trend line maps. Beware, you have to really do some behind the scenes elbow grease to make this possible though. You're gonna have to insert one chart type and then disguise it as another chart type. So for example, if you insert a stacked bar chart, you can format it to look like a population pyramid. Here's another disguise for you. If you add a scatter plot, you can format it to look like a dot plot. This is a really advanced, really sophisticated way of thinking about Excel. It requires some mental gymnastics. It requires the tables that feed into your charts to be formatted completely differently from what you're used to. So that's why you're not going to start here. You're going to start with some of the more beginner and intermediate built-in charts first. And of course, you can mix and match these skills to make things like interactive dashboards. Interactive dashboards use Excel tables, pivot charts, and slicers. They're a great option for internal audiences and technical audiences so that people can get in and use the filters and explore the data and find their own insights. For your non-technical audiences, I'd recommend static dashboards. You make these in Excel, but you save them as a PDF. You attach them to an email and you'd say like, hey team, here are the key insights for our monthly report. Please see attached. Or you might just print them out and bring them to a meeting so that people can circle and star and underline and talk about the findings themselves. It's your turn. Comment below the video. Let me know which of these charts you're already using and which ones you have questions about. I'll read each and every comment, and hopefully you will give me some ideas for future videos that I might make. Future Anne here. I got to South Africa, taught my workshops, and even had some touristy time. What a beautiful country. I got to drive along the coast in one of those double-decker open-air buses right at sunset, right at golden hour. Can't say enough good things about South Africa.